Toronto in my past for 7 years as head of admissions, international liaison representing University of Toronto. And I have with me Rira Fatima, who is an international recruitment officer at Western University and is an alumni of Western University as well. So thank you, Rira, for joining me today. And Rita will be sharing her experience of initially as a student and then briefly talking about Western University as well. So let's get started without wasting too much time. Western University Canada, I know it's very, very famous. It's amongst the top five universities within Canada. And it is located in London, Ontario. Yes, we have a London in Canada as well. And it is located in the center of southwestern Ontario. It's approximately 2 hours drive from Toronto and equidistant between Toronto and Michigan. So very well placed. And it is my favorite university campus across Canada because it is one of the most beautiful university campuses in Canada. I've lived in Canada for 15 years. I moved to Dubai 5 years ago. It has been a fantastic experience. And I have visited every Canadian university, every Canadian college, and I can say this is by far one of the most beautiful university campuses in Canada. It is also amongst the top 1% universities in the world, and it's very culturally diverse. So we have students representing approximately 120 countries across the globe with more than 39,000 plus students on campus. It is a global community, so you will feel at home wherever in the world you're joining Western from. And it's very friendly. London is a university town and offers a lot of opportunities for students to do fun stuff, to engage in co-op work terms, to engage in internships. And what's best, it's very close to Toronto. So it offers us the advantages of being close to Toronto, yet away from it, and giving us that benefit of affordability and low accommodation and living expense. And the commute between London and Toronto, we have a very, very easy commute. Students actually go in the morning sometimes and come back in the evening, or spend their weekends in Toronto and come back to London, Ontario in the evening as well. So if you haven't visited Western University campus, we have on the Western's website, there is a live visit. You can tour the campus and see all the facilities, all the buildings, and whatever you want to see to make sure that this is the right place to be. Unfortunately, I always tell my students that, you know, going to a university and visiting it gives you the perfect feel of, you know, whether this is the right place for you or not, because you are going to spend 4 years in that university itself. So because of the pandemic, Western has put up a really nice campus tour online, and I will share the link at the end of my presentation as well. London is, Western University in London offers over 400 programs with a blend of specializations, majors and minors. So all our programs are very flexible, and you can combine two different programs and do a double major, or you could do two majors and a minor, or you could just specialize in one particular subject area as per your choice. Western also is home to three university colleges on campus, and Western being the main university has the three colleges. So we have Brescia University College, which is a women's only college at Western. It also has an international foundation year, which is a co-ed program. And if you think you're not meeting the admission requirements at Western, you could join the foundation program at Brescia and thereafter move to Western universities, any of the programs that you may be interested in. Huron University College and King's University College are also smaller campus communities on the Western's campus, and they offer different programs with smaller class size. And if you are to join any of these programs on any of these community colleges on Western's campus, you will graduate with a Western degree as well. They have their own admission requirements. Tuition fee is the same, and the admissions program, etc., they're all administered by Western's main administrative authorities. Western offers first entry programs and second entry programs. So our first entry programs are arts and humanities, engineering, health science, kinesiology, nursing, media studies, music, general science, medical science, social science, and management and organizational studies, which is the name of the business program. You will see almost every university has offers their programs and names their programs differently. The business program at Western is named as BMOS, so Bachelor of Management and Organizational Studies. And the second entry programs at Western are Ivy Business School. So you'll do 2 years of the business, the BMOS program. And then in the third and fourth year, if you qualify, you move to the Ivy Business School program. Faculty of Medicine and Dentistry is a second entry program in Canada. So irrespective of the university, you can't start medicine from the first year. It is going to be a second entry program for all across universities across Canada. Bachelors of Education, Law and Social Work are also second entry programs. We offer a vast areas of specialization in engineering. Our engineering faculty is quite unique and offers some unique specializations like green process engineering, integrated engineering, software engineering, engineering with biomedical sciences. And the beauty of Western's programs is that almost every program can be combined with our business degree or with the Faculty of Law. And you could do a joint degree program as well. As you know, if you're targeting engineering, almost 90% of engineers end up doing an MBA program later. So this is actually a quite unique combination. Of course, it is a rigorous program, but it's possible, and you could graduate with 2 qualifications in 5 years. They also offer health sciences. So they have health and aging, health sciences, health promotion, rehabilitation science. And again, it is possible to combine it with the business administration degree from Ivy Business School. The kinesiology department at Western is very popular in Canada and offers a unique specialization in Bachelor of Arts and Bachelor of Sciences. You could also do sports management, clinical kinesiology. It is an upcoming career, and we're seeing an increased enrollment in programs like this. And as you know, post-COVID, a lot of careers are changing. So I would encourage you all to explore some different programs and unique program specializations at the universities that you're targeting within Canada. The media and information studies program is also very popular across Canada and is very unique. It offers media information technoculture, the MIT program, and also the MPI program, which is media and public interest, offered in combination with, again, a joint degree with our Ivy Business School. The medical science program at Western is very comprehensive, and if you see, it's very unique as well, because it gives you an opportunity to study programs like biochemistry with cancer biology, neuroscience, chemical biology, pharmacology, medical biophysics and biochem, again with a combination of Ivy Business School. And these are actually very good programs to get started with, especially if you're looking at probably a career in Faculty of Medicine or Dentistry. But even if you are not going to branch out into medicine or dentistry later, these are unique programs and have great career scope in the industry as well. There is a lot of different programs available under the general science stream as well. And you'll see some unique programs like bioinformatics, which are very upcoming, computer science, data science, genetics and biochemistry, information systems. The integrated science at Western is very unique. Again, all of these, any of these you're planning to take, can be studied as a specialization or combined as a dual major or studied as a major and minor. So you really have to carefully see what is offered as a major and minor. And as you progress along in your 4 years, you get to choose your majors and minors as per your choice and preference. There is also a Bachelor of Arts area of specialization under social science, which offers a unique specialization as well, which is psychology. Psychology at Western is very, very popular. It's amongst one of the top programs at Western, and it's also ranked amongst the top 50 in the world for psychology. They also offer unique specializations in psychology, and you have an option of doing a Bachelor of Arts and Bachelor of Science as well. the Bachelor of Management and Organizational Studies program, which is the business program at Weston, offers 6 areas of specialization: accounting, consumer behavior, finance, human resource, management and legal studies. Commercial aviation management flight and non-flight training program is again a very unique program offered at Weston University, Canada. So we get a lot of queries, and I think the interest is increasing for the commercial aviation management program as well. If students here are, so firstly, Weston accepts all high school curriculums. There is no one curriculum which is preferred over the other. And Canadian universities in general have sort of mapped out the admission requirements for each curriculum, because students apply from all over the world with different high school curriculums, and all universities in Canada are equipped to assess you based on the curriculums you're pursuing. So if you are in the Indian curriculum system, we are going to look at your CBSE grades. And of course, your pre-board results matter, the predicted results and the midterm results are very important. It's also important to understand the prerequisite course requirements for each of the programs I just mentioned. So every university and Weston as well will look at your overall grades, as well as focus on your prerequisite courses depending on the program you're applying. Now, if you are a student of the CHEM schools and pursuing the Indian curriculum, then you are required to submit the IELTS, TOEFL, PTE, one of these English language test scores, in order to be able to meet the English language requirement. If you are pursuing the International Baccalaureate program, Weston will assess you based on your diploma. IB certificate graduates are not eligible to apply, and a minimum grade total of 28 points are needed to apply for any of the programs. If you have your higher level courses and you score 5 or more, then there is a very big likelihood of you getting transfer credits for the higher level subjects. And prerequisites again are very important, so please look at the prerequisite courses and see whether you're meeting the eligibility criteria before you apply. If you're pursuing the GCE advanced level courses and you have 4 AS level courses, you are eligible to apply at Weston. If you've done your A levels, that's perfect, and it will give you, of course, an advantage over other applicants as well. The deadlines to apply, the general deadline is Jan 15th, and but I do encourage all the students to apply as early as possible to meet the admission requirements. Some of the programs do have a supplementary application as well, especially the business program, which is so popular world over. And we do get asked a lot of questions about the supplementary application. Yes, for the business program, you will be required to write some essays. And it's best to start the application early so that you reach the supplementary stage and have enough time to prepare the essays and other applications as well. The English language proficiency requirements, we do definitely look at all of these. And due to pandemic, if there is a situation where you haven't been able to take the exams for any reason, please do write to the university and they will be able to help you assess, you know, whether your grades were good enough, and if they can be waived, they will look at your file on an individual capacity as well. Weston also has an English language center. So if you were not able to take the English language testing as indicated above, then you can also choose to do your English language program to meet the English language requirement at Weston's English language center and start your degree program thereafter. There are some scholarships at Weston University for which you could apply. So the first one is admission scholarships, which is the automatic entrance award. So this is automatic, and this will be based on your final term grades. And when your grades come in July or August, that's the time when Weston decides how much scholarship you're awarded. It ranges anywhere from $2,000 to $10,000, depending on your grades. And every university in Canada has developed a grid system for automatic entrance awards, and that grid is defined by your grades in your final term. Weston also has a quite a large International President Scholarship Award. The deadline for this is Feb 14th. And these are multiple awards given globally for international students. You do need to get nominated by your school and then the application is open to you and you can start the application process. There are other scholarships as well, which you can target in Weston based on your grades, based on your overall profile and extracurricular achievements and awards. So that process as well, whether for Weston or other universities, I think starts quite early. So don't waste your time. Start looking at your options and start exploring what are the scholarships I can apply for and prepare the applications ahead of time. As a student, international student, you are allowed to work on campus. You can work 20 hours a week on campus, and there are lots of positions in different departments paid on-campus positions for international students. So when you reach Canada, when you reach Western or any other university, you can actually contact the Career Center, International Student Center, and they'll be more than willing to help you look at job opportunities available on campus as well. So campus life in London and at Western is quite bustling with a lot of activities. Western offers experiential learning programs through internships. There are 45 plus programs which include the opportunity for work integrated learning. So a lot of experiential learning happening at Western, which makes the Western programs quite unique. And I will invite Rita later to talk about her experiences at Western as well. So in general, Western also offers exchange opportunities and they have multiple exchange partnerships across the globe. So if you're looking at a different experience being a Western student, that's absolutely possible. And they have about 170 programs in 40 countries giving you a unique experience yet being a Western student and paying the same fee. When you come on campus, every university in Canada offers you on-campus accommodation and they have different styles of campus accommodation. Western offers a traditional suite and hybrid style. So all depends what you're looking for, what kind of residence you're looking for. And you have the opportunity of indicating that on the application. Residence has its own deadlines. You have to abide by the deadlines in your application. And if you don't want to live on campus, you could opt for off-campus accommodation as well. And you can find that information on the websites. And there's lots of accommodation available off-campus as well. If you're living on campus, you will have to fill out certain forms and there is a deadline. So I request you all when you reach that stage to please look at all the deadlines. And of course, we are there to help you throughout the process as well. So on the Western's website, you'll see a welcome website which indicates all the admission requirements. Please do log in onto this website and check out your prerequisite course requirements as well. I am based in Dubai. Futures Abroad has an office here as well, and we can help you with the admission requirements and help you understand your prerequisite courses as well. So five steps, please review your admission requirements, mark your deadlines and dates on the calendar, apply on OUAC, my apologies, for international students at Jan 15th, and submit all your additional documents if needed. The supplementary application will indicate what are the documents you need to upload or submit to the respective admissions office. And last but not the least, check your application status and continue to check your supplementary application to make sure that you have completed the application. There is nothing pending, and that's the time when Weston picks up your application for evaluation. So I'm going to quickly play a video and then I'm going to invite Rita to share her experience about Weston as well. Oops, sorry.
I was looking at other universities in Canada, but what I really liked about Western was where it was located. So I was able to really have that city life around London and also have like really be in the campus. And I really enjoyed that.
There are two things you're looking for. First, the reputation of the university since you'll be finishing a graduate degree. The second thing is the strength of the specific program you're looking at. So these two things I found here at Western. This is why I chose it.
I love how many options are here for clubs, and they are really diverse, and they really help me de-stress from studying to manage better my social life, and I think that's really good for me.
If you're coming to Western, don't be afraid to step out of your comfort zone. Try to get involved with those clubs and activities organized by Western. Then,
don't stay in your own small circle. Be open and be glad to meet people. Everybody is just friendly.
I like that during the first week there was so much going on, and it keeps you in like this positive headspace. There's always a support system around you, and it's just people that you meet, and like all of a sudden they're like the family you have here because you live with them and you do everything with them essentially.
I'll say all my professors are really, really, really kindly. They're really friendly. They talk to me a lot. I know it's a huge class, so like for some of my classes has a few hundred students, but even though they still like came to us to answer all my questions.
I felt supported, I felt embraced by the environment and by people. So I felt it's not just a school, but it's almost like a family.
You get to leave here being like, I went to university, which was a place that you now consider a home.
Living at Residence has been really great and has given me a chance to meet a lot of other people, especially international students.
You can feel the diversity from the very first day you come in.
I would definitely recommend Western to other international students. It has a good global reputation. It has the best student experience in Canada. And it is one of the most beautiful campuses in Canada as well.
If I could say one word about my experience at Western, I would definitely say amazing.
Thank you, everybody. I hope you enjoyed the video. I am now going to invite Rita Fatima, who is the International Recruitment Officer at Western and also an alumni of Western. Welcome, Rita.
And thank you, Fatima.
Thank you for your time. So please, we would love to hear your experience first, initially as a student at Western and now working at Western and how you got that opportunity.
Absolutely. So I graduated from Western University in 2018, so just a couple of years ago. I did an honor specialization in health sciences. And although I initially went in with different expectations, what I loved most about my experience at Western was the fact that I actually got so many opportunities to explore some of the things that I was interested in. So by nature, the health sciences program has a lot of practicum opportunities and other ways for, you know, students to explore what they're really interested in. So they essentially ask us to think beyond our degree in terms of how we want to be employed, what we want to be doing afterwards. And so throughout our program, there was always a strong focus on, okay, what do you do with this degree specifically? So a lot of the students that I worked with or the students that I studied with, they went on to study rehab sciences or physiotherapy, occupational therapy, public health, audiology, things like that. For me personally, I actually ended up taking quite a different path just because I explored different opportunities that, again, were also available at Western. By volunteering, by working with the international team at Western, I just found that I fell in love with international education. So I ended up taking that path. And now I do actually recruit for the health sciences faculty at Western. So it's kind of a nice full circle situation. And yeah, I definitely loved studying at Western, and now I love working at Western. As you mentioned in your presentation, Vandana, like the student experience is truly amazing. You feel like you're part of a community from day one, regardless of where you come from, regardless of, you know, whether or not you're a domestic student or international student. There's just a lot of diversity on campus, and I just I always, like, from day one, I just felt like I was at home. And that's, again, because Western focuses on fostering a strong sense of community, but also giving lots of opportunities for students to engage with each other. So there's lots of clubs available on campus, whether they be cultural or with regard to something you're interested in, such as law or business or something else, or they could even be passions and interests, such as dance or music. And, you know, these kinds of opportunities create that sense of community that we love talking about. And I think it's definitely one of the best parts of studying at Western. That's kind of been my experience. I don't know if you had any other questions or anything like that, or if Lolly had any questions to ask, we'd be happy to answer.
Perfect. So I have one follow-up question, which I get asked a lot from students. So I'm sure you applied to other universities as well. So what stood out for you at Western that you chose Western?
Absolutely. So I was actually also a 1 of 5 applicant. So 1 of 5 applicants from the OUAC are people, anyone who's outside of Ontario. So for me, applying to Western specifically was because I saw, first of all, the beautiful campus. For me, it was, I did come from BC, which is known to be very beautiful. And to me, you know, having Western look as beautiful as it did was definitely a big factor. But the other thing was that I was very interested in the health sciences program at Western. I was very interested in going into public health or looking at healthcare in a more holistic, systems-oriented way. And for me, I found that the health sciences program provided that kind of perspective. And I did come away with a very good understanding, not just of the healthcare system, but of how to look at different systems in that sort of, in the way that health sciences taught me. So those were kind of my two main reasons. I wanted to study the health sciences program, and I just thought the campus was absolutely gorgeous. So those were definitely the reasons that I chose to apply.
That's fantastic. And I've heard that the research facilities at Weston, especially for science students, are quite unique in comparison to what a lot of other universities offer. So did you feel the same way as well, being a science student?
Absolutely. In health sciences specifically, especially in nursing, the faculty has a state-of-the-art nursing lab with simulations and you know, things that are very much state-of-the-art. And we were lucky enough to get access to that while we were students. But even apart from that, for example, in medical sciences, they have opportunities available to students that usually are not available at the undergraduate level. For example, in medical sciences, you can specialize in your third year in neuroscience specifically. So one of the streams is neuroscience. And undergraduate students in that stream are actually given a lot of access to our state-of-the-art neuroscience labs and things like that. And again, that's an opportunity that is very rare because Western has state-of-the-art equipment, researchers, everything that we specialize in specifically for neuroscience, and undergraduate students get a special chance to kind of take a look at that.
Oh, fantastic. That's amazing.
I just wanted to ask
yes?
a question either to Vandana or to Ritha.
Yeah.
Now, Vandana, you told about IELTS, the requirement for IELTS. A student has done first language English, still the student will require IELTS exam?
Yep, so I can help answer that. Usually what happens is if you do have a question regarding specifically whether or not you would be exempted from IELTS, I would highly recommend that you reach out to admissions at Western. You can email them at welcome@uw.ca. I can drop that in the chat as well, and tell them about your specific situation, the high school that you're coming from, and whether or not you would be given that exemption. So I'm just going to put that in the chat, and you can go ahead and email them, and you'll hopefully
hear back. This is what the students usually ask me. Then even that's what the same thing I tell them. So since I met you all today, that's why I thought of asking you all that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's the first question. The second question is, there are community colleges which are linked with Western University. Mm-hmm. Now, when they are studying at Western, they have the chance of taking an internship and get the financial benefit out of it. Do they have the same in the community colleges? Because I'm talking to you because some of our students are financially not well off. So will they have the facility like once they go there, work and at the same time study? Because we had a student 3 years before, she was an excellent student, art, everything, but she lost her father after the first year. So she had to come back to Dubai, then work here for 1 year, mm-hmm. then go back and, you know, see, we do not know what is the situation. So if such situations come up, how will the students take up? I just wanted a brief idea so that, you know, especially now with the pandemic, children are asking me that question, ma'am. Financially, we are finding it difficult. How will they help us? Will the scholarships continue after the first year? Or is it only for the first year? So just share a little bit light on that.
Rita, do you want me to start on this? So I'll just start answering one by one. And Rita, feel free to add in later. So the scholarship especially, and that's not just Western, all universities. Let's say you get a scholarship. I'm just taking a hypothetical number. Or 50,000, every university gives you 1/4 each year. And you have to sort of keep your grades up. And some awards are renewable, some not. And this I'm talking general Canada-wide. Questions students are asking about affordability and getting sort of working and making, earning money, you know, realistically, students can work part-time. Whether it's a college or a university, but in my experience, and Rita will share hers as well, that what you earn on an hourly basis work permits to on a student capacity, you're only going to be earning, you know, just some pocket money. And it's not going to be enough to meet your tuition fee or other related expenses to enable you to study or complete your education at a university. And Rita, please share your example as well, as being a student and, you know, yeah.
Absolutely. So I paid domestic tuition. I definitely do agree with Vandana that, you know, said, you know, working part-time may not necessarily be enough to cover the complete tuition cost of university, even for domestic students. So we do understand that Western University specifically has limited scholarships. We do know that there's the International President Scholarship. There's also admission scholarships, but I think it is a definite factor for you to consider when applying to Western or other Canadian universities to look at your financial capacity beforehand and to make sure that you're able to take that decision with that in mind.
Yeah. And if there are students who are joining, let's say, colleges with the expectation of moving into the universities, and a lot of universities have articulation agreements with colleges, and students can do that. And being a college student as well, they can work part-time. There is no problem. But again, what they're going to earn is just going to be some pocket money, you know. It's not going to be enough to overcome the tuition expenses.
Thank you.
Most welcome. Any other questions, we'd be more than happy to answer. But if not, in general, you know, I would recommend...
I put it in chat, if you can check chat.
Okay. In general, I would like to recommend, you know, please advise the students to apply early so that they can complete their application on time. Canada is getting popular. Can we talk about the International Foundation Program with an affiliate college as a pathway to a degree at Western? And does this apply to students who may wish to study engineering at Western but do not meet their admission threshold? Rita, would you like to answer this with, I think it's... the Brescia International Foundation pathway, yeah.
Yeah, so this wouldn't necessarily, to my understanding, it wouldn't apply specifically to engineering. It can be looked at for other programs that do have a bridge or that are available both on the Brescia campus or elsewhere, but not for engineering specifically. It wouldn't be available because Brescia, again, is a more of a liberal arts center college. It has some science programs, but there wouldn't be that corollary between Brescia and Western specifically for engineering. And I was wondering if you were talking more about the pathways program, such as the conditional admissions for people who don't yet meet English language requirements, or is this a different program that you were talking about?
It's a transition program that sometimes universities have in affiliation with colleges. So for students that may have financial constraints that they can't go straight into university or may have not met the admission thresholds criteria. So
I do understand a little bit better. Okay, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So as an example, at Fanshawe College, which is also located in London, Ontario, there are students that choose to do a sort of bridging program where they do study at first within Fanshawe College with the grades that they have in order to qualify later on for programs at Western, which do include engineering sometimes. They do also include nursing and other similar programs as well. So that is a possibility. That would be something that you could also discuss once again with welcome at uw.ca because they do answer questions about college transfers. I'm also going to drop a link to more information about college transfers specifically for Western. And if you wanted to add on more to that, feel free to go ahead.
No, I totally echo what you're saying. But also, Lena, sometimes, you know, it's, see, for Western, you can put in three program choices in the OUAC application. And I do encourage students doing that because what happens if you're not meeting the requirements for the direct entry program at Western for the first choice, then Western will look at the other two options that you put in. And sometimes it's also good to get a foot in the door because first year is a general year in Canada, in all the universities. So it gives students an opportunity to, you know, upgrade their GPA, and then they can obviously transfer into the main program at the end of first year or beginning of second year. But if they want, both for affordability and to also, if they're not meeting the requirements, they could also transition through Fanshawe College at Western thereafter.
Great, thank you. Thanks.
All right, so if there are no more questions, I'm happy to answer any questions you have or if Lali has any more for students. But if not, I'm available in Dubai. I'd be more than happy to, you know, talk to students and discuss their personal situation with them or understand, help them understand the prerequisite courses, etc., and assist in the application as well.
I have one more question, sorry. It's about what, you know, with the pandemic and the situation now, it's becoming difficult for students to afford perhaps applying directly to go to study in Canada. If they opt to remain here in the UAE and study at one of the universities here, but obviously would say, for example, something reputable like Harriet Watt or, yeah, would they be able to transfer into second year Western, or is it starting from scratch into first year? So how easy is it for students that may choose to do a year here in the UAE and then transfer to study at Western?
You know, transfer credits, I mean, generally speaking in Canada, it is possible. In some faculties like engineering are quite rigid on their admission transfer credit requirements. But you know, when a student is applying, there is always a risk of losing some credits because the assessment is based first, you get admitted, and then transfer credit evaluation. That transfer credit evaluation is based on the courses you've studied, let's say at Harriet Watt here or CUD here, and they match the curriculum and this child's performance in each of those credits. And that defines how many credits are awarded vis-a-vis not. Possibility, but there is no guarantee you get one full year of transfer credit assessment done, like 100% credits awarded in a transfer situation. But generally speaking, usually, typically Canadian universities, business and engineering is quite tough when it comes to transfer credit evaluation. Most of the other faculties are still more liberal and lenient and, you know, happy to look at transfer credits coming from other countries as well.
Great, thank you. Thanks.
Vandana, if there are any leaflets, if you could mail to either Lena could mail, or anyway, then I could share it on the Teams for the students so that, you know, I will share these two links with them so that, you know, they get an idea and then they can get back if required, then I can call you for a session.
For sure.
Because, yes.
Yes, Lali, I will share the link to the recording as well as all the links in the chat for the students and parents that they can refer back to, and with the, as well, the connection and the contact for Vandana Futures Abroad.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Thank you, Lena.
Yeah. Thank you, Vandana. Thank you, Rita. This has been very informative. We really appreciate your time. And thank you, Lali, for joining the session tonight. And we wish you all the best. Thank you, guys.
Thank you so much for organizing.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye.